I think that there's something to be said for really exploring the way in which maybe wokeness can stand on its own two feet when it isn't intermingled with capitalism. A big part of what I take aim at in the book isn't just the woke ideology in and of its own right, but its merger with capitalism, which actually taints both the progressive values that corporations are asked to be stewards of, as well as tainting corporate purpose in and of its own right as well. And so that's actually what the heart of the book is about, more so than criticizing one end of the political spectrum or the other.
Because there are so many social scientists who lean to the left, there was a marked attempt to avoid defining authoritarianism broadly enough to allow for the possibility of a left-wing authoritarianism. Well, after several decades of this, there was a political scientist who sort of defined it, and he gave it sort of three basic components. One was this idea of anti-conventionalism, the idea that everybody who is not of my moral standard is somehow inferior and lesser. And this obviously exists on the left. The idea is that if you don't believe, like many members of the left, this makes you a bigot. You're a racist, sexist, bigot, homophobe, cisnormative jerk. And this means that your perspective is somehow lesser. You don't belong. You're not fit company for anyone else. Then there is a second element, and that is top-down censorship. The idea from the left is that you ought to be censored because of this. We're going to use the mechanisms of power to shut you up in order to protect everybody else. We definitely, definitely have to shut you up. And then third, there's an element of revolutionary aggression that is sort of connected to left-wing authoritarianism. The idea here being that the institutions are responsible for all of our ills and they need to be torn down.
One of the things liberals have done is really tried to police conservative humor recently. Jon Stewart, very effective at ridicule. And he had that run for a while, The Daily Show, where he was really moving the needle, even on policy. Republicans were terrified of this guy. And he was just roasting them. And the show was very influential. And then he dumped out and now lives on a farm, grew a beard. And when conservatives try to enter that realm of comedy, the liberals don't want to do it because they know how effective comedy is. They know how effective ridicule is. And number one, if you allow conservatives to have that in their arsenal, that could be very damaging to the liberal cause. But when conservatives are funny, it also humanizes them.